again. I'm Jeff Hirsch. We're here at the Traders Expo in Las Vegas. It's November 2019. I'm with Ed Modla. He is the Director of Retail Education at the Options Industry Council, the OIC. And you're telling us detailed, like, recipes and instructions for options strategies.
Recipes and the ingredients.
The ingredients, the whole thing. But the detail is what is I'm finding so impressive right now. The Iron Condor.
Mm-hmm.
Cool name.
It is.
Sounds like something from a war movie, you know, with Stallone in it or something.
Yeah.
What is the Iron Condor?
It makes sense the way those names are derived. Investors like to sell options that when they use them. Of course, there's the time and a place to buy them, but selling options is one of the biggest motivations that investors have.
Getting premium.
Getting premium, capturing that, and taking advantage of the natural time decay of options. So focusing on the sell side is the Iron Condor.
Okay.
Selling a call and a put on either side of the stock gives the investor all the premium that they're looking for, but of course that comes along with risk in both sides.
So you're looking to capture a range in the middle of something, correct?
So it's a neutral market environment,
right.
You're right. So you're selling a call, selling a put, wanting the stock to stay in between those strike prices and have them expire out of the money,
okay,
knowing you've got risk on the table. So the Iron Condor then further buys out of the money calls and puts outside of that to contain the risk on both sides of the market.
So you start with, is it the call above the current price of the underlying and the puts below?
Traditionally, yes. Calls above the current price,
selling
puts
a call
below.
Above, selling a put below.
Yep.
And the Condor part of it is you go another step out.
Yeah, you go further out on both sides and you buy a cheaper call and a cheaper put. So you're getting a credit on both sides of this.
So you buy a put and a call. You're selling one and you're buying one.
Yes, so there's four sides to this trade.
Okay.
Selling a more expensive call and put and then buying two cheaper calls and puts. And the reason why you're doing that is really just to protect the risk.
Is it like two call spreads?
You can consider it two call spreads. You can look at it as two strangles. There's different
two
ways
strangles.
To name this. You're selling
I
a strangle
like
and then buying another one. There's different ways to name this, but the
so
Iron Condor is popular and it's got a name because it's
two strangles.
Like strategy.
Two strangles make an Iron Condor.
That's right.
So then what's the difference between the Condor and the Butterfly, the Iron Butterfly?
Well,
and not the old 60s rock band.
Okay, that's where I was going with it. So let's make that distinction. It's actually rather simple. The Iron Butterfly is another premium selling strategy.
Right.
You're neutral. You think the stock's going to stay in a tight range. But in this case, maybe you're a little more confident that the stock is going to settle at a particular price. So the difference here is, as you said, instead of going above the stock to sell your call and below the stock to sell your put, the Iron Butterfly sells the call and put at the same strike, right in the middle. Almost like selling a straddle.
Straddle.
And then buying a strangle outside. So you're selling the same strike.
So an Iron Butterfly is a straddle and a strangle.
Yes.
And an Iron Condor is two strangles.
That's right.
Super cool.
And the iron Butterfly is a little more aggressive, keeping the stock near
in
the
a tighter range.
In a tighter range. You can make more money because the premium should be higher, but you have a tighter range of profitability. A little more aggressive
you
on
that. You explain this better than anybody.
I'm trying.
Excellent stuff. Thanks, everybody, and thank you, Ed. Really
good to be here. Thank you.
Great stuff.